haven't heard any more screaming from across the river. Maybe that Mexican boy must be dead.
Yeah, if he's lucky, he died. I doubt three Comanches would pause more than a night to cut up a Mexican.
That poor innocent neophyte didn't even have a gun with him to kill himself.
Nobody had a knife. Knife's sufficient. Yeah, if you know where to cut.
Where would you cut?
Cut the jugular. It's right here. You give it a poke at it with a big mesquite thorn or whack at it with a broken bottle if you're left without no knife.
Me, I'd shoot myself in the head.
That could go wrong. Never go sticking no gun in your mouth unless it's a shotgun.
How could it go wrong? It's kind of hard to miss your head with a gun in your mouth.
Oh, it ain't. A bullet could ricochet off a bone or two and come out your ear. Still be healthy enough, they could torture you for a week. Shove the barrel of the gun against an eye and pull, that's sure. Brains will blow out the back of your head, and then if some squaw comes along and chews off your balls and your pecker, you won't know the difference.
They got no right chewing on people like that.
Worse than that, Adams.
What's worse than having your pecker chewed off?
Well, having them tie the end of your gut to a dog. Chase that dog around camp. There's about 50 feet of your gut stretched out in front of you for the kids to eat.
To eat?
Yeah, them Comanche brats. They eat gut like our kids eat candy. Or you might run a stick up your fundament. Set it on fire. That way your guts will be done quick when you pull them out.
What's a fundum?
It's a hole in your body.
Yeah, it ain't your nose or your mouth or your goddamn ear.